Welcome, rat fans, to the Rodent Video Collection, tape number 2, cataloguing my adventures on the ski slopes of Sars Fay and Zermatt, winter retreats for the stars. So settle down now in your living room for 1 hour's worth of scintillating entertainment. Errol, run VT! The sign up there. Yeah, Brig. What a stupid name, eh? Where's the mountains then, Kev? Where's the snow? Hey.
We'll see the snow soon enough, Roland. Errol is going to meet us here with the Ratmobile, and then we must drive through the valley up to Sars Fay, where our luxury chalet is located. I didn't feel sick once on that train, Roland. The flight was very good too, wasn't it?
Of course it was. That was Switzerland's own airline we flew on. Yeah, 10 times better than Kev here. I can't wait to get to the snow and start skiing, eh, Kev? Where's our chauffeur then?
Ooh, Errol?
Yeah.
He said he'd meet us from the train, but he's not here yet. He's got miles to drive, though.
Yeah, well, that shouldn't take him long. He set off from London 2 days ago, so where is he? Organisation, Kevin, is the key to this little trip. Otherwise, it'll turn into a right disaster. Is that clear?
Yes, Roland.
Right, let's find a taxi, as we have no Ratmobile.
It'll be expensive, Roland. Can't we wait till Errol arrives?
Nah, we'll be here till Christmas, Kevin.
It's only 5 days to Christmas, Roland.
Oh, Kevin, do be quiet now. What's the German for taxi? Let's have a look. I don't know why they can't speak English over here. Makes it all so difficult. It's most inconvenient. They all speak English in Palma Nova. No problems there. Now, what's a taxi? Ah, here it is. Yeah.
Yes, it's taxi, Roland. It's the same word. Oh, look, Roland, look. Look, it's Errol. He's arrived. Thank goodness.
About time to... Hello, Roland. Hello, Kevin. Oh, dear, it's miles over here. I'm exhausted, I am. Why couldn't we have gone to Wales for Christmas? It's a lot nearer. International superstars do not spend their Christmas holidays in the Rhondda Valley, Errol. I'm sorry, but that's the way it is.
I suppose you've got a point there, Roland. Here, I got stopped at the Swiss customs. They told me hamsters are not allowed to drive cars in Switzerland.
Well,
I told them I got a valid driving license. Haven't I? What more do you want? So I just drove off. They were dumbfounded. Didn't know what to say.
Fascinating. But I think we ought to be making our way up the valley to our luxury chalet.
Yeah, you're right, Kev. I can't wait. Come on. I'm getting quite used to driving on the other side of the road. Quite an accomplished international driver now I am. There's some lovely shallots round here, isn't there? I just can't wait to see this luxurious chalet you booked for me, Kev.
It'll be a surprise, Roland.
Here we are, Roland. Well, where is it then?
Where's what, Roland?
The luxurious chalet you booked for me. Where is it?
You're looking at it, Roland.
Where?
There.
It's a shed.
It's not, Roland. It's our luxurious chalet called Liebestraum.
What's that mean?
It's German for my dream.
My nightmare would have been more applicable to that shack, Kevin.
Well, I'm sorry, but I didn't name the chalet. I just booked it for you at great expense.
How much?
£5.30 for 3 weeks.
No wonder it's a shed for £5.30. What's the 30p for, then?
Oh, that's for Lulu.
Who?
Lulu, the St. Bernard dog. They threw her in with the chalet for an extra 30p.
How wonderful, Kevin.
I thought so, Roland. I booked it through Darcy DeFarcy's travel bureau. He said I'd be a fool not to take it because it's in great demand.
Great demand, I ask you. Look at it. I mean, who'd want to come here for a holiday? I've told you before about Darcy DeFarcy. How can I invite Petula Clark and Sasha Distel up here? What an embarrassment. I'll be the laughing stock of the showbiz world.
I don't know what you're moaning about, Roland. I'm going to thoroughly enjoy staying here at Liebestraum.
Course you are. Got no standards, that's why. I mean, look at it. What a dump. Fancy expecting an international superstar to stay in a shack like this.
Excuse me, Roland. Could I offer a little advice here? We could easily do it up. Just give it a quick lick of paint, brush away the cobwebs, and then it'll look like a superstar's alpine retreat. It'll be as good as new.
Put a bum under it and blow it to pieces, that's my advice.
You're ungrateful, that's your trouble, Roland.
I'm an international superstar, Kevin.
I know, you are wonderful, Roland, but you're also ungrateful. Cost me £5.30 for our 3 week holiday here. I had to save up for this.
I wish you hadn't bothered, Kevin. I'd rather stay in a sewer at King's Cross.
I wouldn't.
No one asked you, Errol.
Sorry, Roland. Shall we make our way indoors and inspect the interior?
I dread to think what that's like. Go on, Kev, you go in first.
It's very cosy in here.
Let me have a look. Cramp would have been the word I'd have used.
Well, it's cramped and cosy. Oh, look, there's Lulu the St. Bernard.
That's a Pyrenean mountain dog, you fool. It's also as stiff as a board. Oh, it's lovely in here, isn't it, Roland? All we need is a few pictures of the Rhondda Valley for a bit of decoration.
A luxury chalet turned out to be a shed. So Roland turned to skiing.
Come on, Kofi. Let's get out onto those slopes. We'll soon have you skiing. You stick by me, son.
How do we get up there to the slopes then, Roland?
Eggs, Kevin, eggs.
No, thank you. I've had my breakfast. How do we get to the ski slopes?
That's what I'm trying to tell you, Kevin. Eggs. You travel up in cars called eggs. There they are over there. See them going up? Whee!
I thought they were called cable cars.
No, the small ones are called eggs. The bigger ones are called cable cars.
Oh, I see. Well, I shall probably feel sick, whatever size they are. I'm scared, Roland.
Don't be silly, Kevin. They're quite safe.
No, I'm not going. I'm scared.
You'll never get to ski at the Olympics if you're too scared to even travel in a cable car, Kevin.
You're right, Roland.
Well, come on, Kev, come on. Let's get up to that cable car station. This is the ticket office here. Two to the top, mate. We're going skiing.
Wayne, what did you get?
What's he on about?
He says, where do you want to go?
I just told him, haven't I? Two to the top, mate. Two to the top. Here's the money.
You're meant to speak German, Roland.
We should speak English. We're in the common market, aren't we? I mean, he should speak English.
Want a bit of
violin? What? Never mind, love. Never mind. We've got a bit of a problem here.
Switzerland isn't in the common market. Leave this to me, Roland, would you please? Können wir bitte Schweibeleiter bis zur Bergstation haben?
Ja, das kostet 44 Franken für zwei Personen.
Oh, ja. Danke schön.
You're right, Noel. Where's the tickets? Thank you. Come on, let's go. How much do these tickets cost then?
44 francs.
Phew, outrageous. Well, just to go up a mountain, how ridiculous. Come on, in for a penny, in for a pound, I suppose.
We're off. I mustn't look down, otherwise I shall feel sick. Oh, look at the view, Roland, it's wonderful. Oh, Roland, I feel sick.
This is the second stage, Kemp. Yeah, this car will take us right to the top. Yeah, then we can start skiing. Why do they have to be so slow? I do not know.
Oh, I feel sick now, Roland.
You can't travel anywhere, can you, Kemp? At least you got all the gear on, haven't you, Kemp? Yeah.
Yes, I wonder if I'll be able to ski, though.
Yeah, of course you will. It's easy. I'll show you. Just you watch me when we get out on the slopes. There'll be no stopping me, Kev.
Have you skied before, Roland?
No. But I can tackle anything, Kev. Just you watch me.
You are wonderful, Roland. I wonder if these cable cars ever get stuck or fall off the cable.
Nah, don't worry, Kev. They hardly ever have accidents on these things.
I suppose you're right, Roland. It's a pity Errol couldn't come skiing, isn't it?
Yeah, well, someone's got to stay and get the lunch ready, haven't they, Kev?
I suppose so, Roland. Isn't the view wonderful from here?
Oh, look at all that snow, Kev.
Yes, isn't that wonderful, Roland? It's all white!
Yeah, well, snow usually is, Kev, isn't it?
I know, but it's wonderful. Look at that mountain top over there.
Yeah. Fantastic, Kev, fantastic.
Roland, why have we stopped?
We haven't, Kev, don't be stupid.
We have, Roland.
Oh, yeah, so we have. this often happens. We'll be moving again in a minute, just you see.
Roland, we're not moving.
I know we're not, Kevin. I can see for myself, thank you very much. We'll be moving again shortly.
Why aren't we moving, Roland?
I don't know, Kevin.
We're stuck, Roland. We're stuck. Help, 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 help. We're stuck. Help, help. Oh, I knew I shouldn't have come on one of these things. Help, help. I want to get out. Help, help.
Have you quite finished, Kevin? Getting hysterical will not solve the problem. We'll just have to wait.
We'll be here all night and freeze to death. Imagine being stuck for days in a cable car. Help, someone help. Help, there's a superstar stuck in a cable car. Help, let me out.
How can you get out, Kevin, when we're stranded thousands of feet above the ground?
How far above the ground, Roland?
Thousands of feet, Kevin, thousands of feet.
Thousands of feet?
Typical, look at him, he's fainted. Oh, well, the last time he did that was when he received my bill at the Alton Hotel. Wait a minute. We're on the move.
We're moving, Roland. We're moving.
Hooray, we're moving again. I told you the breakdown wouldn't last long, didn't I, Kev? Wait a minute. This is no good. We're going down instead of up. I want to get to the ski slopes.
I want to get back to the chalet. I've had enough, Roland.
But we haven't been anywhere yet.
I don't care. I've had quite enough of cable cars, thank you, Roland.
Oh, hello, viewers. Errol here. As you can see, I'm in a forest here, and this is a pine forest. The sort of pine trees that you find in Wales. Well, not quite, because these are Swiss pine trees. And I'm trying to find a nice bushy one to give Roland as a surprise for Christmas. Now, I'm going to go off now and see if I can find a bushy pine tree.
La 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 la. Ooh, I think I could get some decorations first from this shop here. Ooh, I think I shall surprise Roland first and take a little Christmas tree home. This silver one would be lovely in our chalet.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Ich möchte diesen Baum haben, bitte.
Da kostet 12 Franken, bitte.
Oh, ja, ja, danke schön. Oh, Roland will be pleased. Oh, I do love Christmas time. Oh, danke schön. Ja, ja. Oh, this tree is lovely. Roland will be pleased. Oh, I do hope I see Father Christmas this year.
There must be a tree here somewhere that would fit into our chalet. Oh, now that looks about right. That's nice and bushy. Yes, I think I shall cut this tree down. I always say I like a nice big tree at Christmas. Now I get me axe and we'll soon have this little beauty down. Hey, while they're both out, I think I'll nip out and try and buy a Christmas tree as a surprise when they come back. Timber! I can't wait to surprise Roland with this one.
Roland! Roland! I got a surprise for you! Oh, he's not here.
Ding dong merrily, and I. Now, this must be the Christmas tree shop. I'm climbing a tree, Dinker.
Was heißt das gesagt?
A tree. I want a tree. I'm climbing a tree. Shall I draw it for you?
Was hat it again?
Oh, what's she on about now? Tree, Christmas tree. Look, in here. In me book. Have a look. In me book. Have a look. At Roland.
Oh, a Weihnachtsbaum.
Yeah, yeah. Last. I thought I was going to be here till Easter. Then I'd be after Easter eggs, wouldn't I? nothing. Forget it. How much?
Bitte?
Money. I've no idea of this foreign currency. Oh, is that my tree?
Yeah, that should be an Weihnachtsbaum.
Jingle bells.
The green grass are warm. Roland, I got a surprise for you.
What you got there, Errol?
Hello, Kevin. It's a surprise Christmas tree for Roland.
But I've just bought him a tree, a silver one.
Oh, well, never mind. We can have two now. Help me decorate it, will you, Kevin, please?
Certainly, Errol, but don't you think it's a little on the large side?
No, I always like a big tree at Christmas. You can't beat it, Kevin.
You can't move in the chalet either, Errol.
Nonsense. Cut a few branches off, and then we can stand it up. Now, where's my axe?
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Kevin! Errol! I got a surprise for you.
It's Roland! Quick, hide the trees!
Mine's too big to hide. What are we going to do?
Oh, no. It'll spoil our surprise.
Close your eyes, lads, because here I am with a surprise. Da-da. Wait a minute. What's this thing here?
Oh, I bought you a Christmas tree as a surprise, Roland. How can we move in here with a tree that size? What's this silver thing as well?
It's my surprise present to you, Roland. It's a pretend Christmas tree.
But I've just bought one as a surprise for you, Kev. It's going to look like a Black Forest ghetto in here with all these trees. We'll have to get rid of yours, Errol.
No, sorry, Roland. Mine's not going. I got up early to chop that down. Exhausted me, that did.
Right. Kev's tree will have to go then.
No, Roland. I bought it as a present for you. Anyway, it's an everlasting Christmas tree.
Right, we'll toss for it. Heads, Errol's tree goes. Tails, we chop Errol's tree down a bit. Right, here we go then. Tails, you lose. Sorry, Errol, we chop it down. Hooray!
Looks like Errol lost again. Roland chopped his tree to pieces.
I must say, your tree looks a lot better now. It's had a bit of a trim, Errol.
You've ruined it, Roland. That was a beautiful tree, that was, and now you've gone and ruined it.
There was no room in here, Errol, for your bushy little number. You can now decorate the tree, while Kev and I go and buy the Christmas turkey. Now here's the box of dangly things. There you are, Errol.
Why should I?
Because it's the Christmas season, isn't it, Errol? The season of goodwill. So dang a shirt, or whatever they say. Come on, Kev, let's walk into Sars Fay. Bring the shopping list. Albedas, Drain, Errol, or whatever they say.
Well, I won't bother with these. I've got a much better idea.
Right, Kev, have you got the list for Christmas shopping?
No, I gave it to Lulu. Oh, dear. It looks as though she's eaten it.
How could she have eaten it? She hadn't moved since we've been here.
It must have dropped out of her mouth while you were dragging her through the streets. Why you insist on bringing her everywhere, I do not know.
I like Lulu. She's an outstanding example of a prize St. Bernard.
I've never seen a St. Bernard looking like that before. She's a Pyrenean mountain dog, you fool.
How do you know?
It's obvious, isn't it? This isn't getting us anywhere. Where's the shopping list?
I don't know.
Typical. Well, we'll have to try and remember everything. Where's my phrase book? Now, what's the German for turkey? Here we are. Truten. Truten. Come on, let's go and buy Truten.
You don't pronounce it like that, Roland.
Look, I'm a man of the world. Don't you talk to me about languages. I'm fluent in French, German, Spanish, Japanese, you name it.
Why do you need the phrase book, then?
Refresher course, kid. Refresher course. Come on. Come on, Kev. Look what they got here. They got Heidelbeer Schnitters, Joanna's Beer Schnitters, Rubel Torts, Tooten Schnitters. They must have Tootens in here. Come on, Kev. Come on.
I don't think so, Roland.
You leave this to me, Kevin. Guten Morgen. One Tooten Denkershire.
Bitte?
Tooten. One Tooten Denkershire.
Das ist das größte Brot, das wir machen.
What's she on about, Kev?
She said that's the largest loaf they bake.
But we want a turkey, not a loaf of bread. Truten, we want a truten.
But we're in a baker's, not a butcher's shop.
And why didn't you say so earlier?
I did try to tell you, Roland.
All right, Noel. Come on, come on. Why is it so difficult to do a simple job like buying a turkey? I mean, why don't they write the signs in English here? I shall write a letter to the Swiss Tourist Board. Telling them to change all the signs into English.
They speak German here. I don't see that there's any problem at all. I can speak a little German because I swatted up before I came out here.
Well, of course you did, you little know-all. Well, as you're so clever, when it comes to speaking the German lingo, you can do the shopping and I'll take Lulu for a walk.
But Roland, I won't be able to carry everything on my own.
You speak the lingo, you sort something out, Kev. Lulu and I are off to find a bit of excitement in this town. Bye-bye, Kev. Come on, Lulu. Say woof-woof, girl. She never stops talking, does she, eh? Come on, girl. Come on, come on.
Bye, Roland. At least it'll be easier now to do the shopping. I think Roland is very inconsiderate. He expects the whole world to speak English. Ah, Mexican! This is the butcher's. Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Ich möchte gerne einen Truten haben, bitte.
Ja, das wäre der recht so.
Oh ja, danke schön. I got the turkey. Now all I need to get is some vegetables. And I mustn't forget to buy the Christmas presents for Roland and Errol.
We'll have a little mid-morning snack, eh, Lulu? Yeah, exhausting buying presents, isn't it? Yeah. If only people had speak English all over the world, we wouldn't have this problem, of course. Yeah. Posh in here, isn't it, Lulu? Ah! Here's the waitress. I'll surprise her by speaking the lingo. Buongiorno, mademoiselle. Ich kleine nicht bowl of dog food for mein Kinderfriende here, and I'll have a traditionally Swiss dish. What you got?
Ich kann kein Wort verstehen.
Yeah, something Swiss, you know, a Swiss dish. Famous, traditionally.
Ah, Sie möchten eine Schweizer Spezialität. Probieren Sie Raclette?
What's she rambling on about, Lulu?
Raclette. You would like to try raclette?
I don't want to play tennis, love. No. She's asking me if I want a tennis racket now. No sporty. No sporty. Eat.
Yeah, raclette is a traditional Swiss meal with cheese and tiny potatoes.
Ooh, well, that sounds good, doesn't it? Yeah, we'll have one of them. Yeah, don't forget a plate of meat for the dog.
This dog isn't real.
Use your imagination, Garcoli. What's the matter with you? What on earth's going on here? They must be ill. Oi, are you ill? See, doctor must be in here somewhere.
The doctor today, you see.
Hello, Roland!
Oh, Kev, there you are. Look, they're ill. Get a doctor. What's German for doctor? I can't find it in my book. What's German for doctor? They've probably eaten rocket, that's why they're ill.
They're yodeling, Roland!
Yeah, well, then we better get into an hospital. They sound as though they're in pain.
Yodeling is an old form of singing. It's traditional in Switzerland, common to mountain folk.
So they're not ill?
No, Roland.
Oh, well, that's fantastic then, isn't it? Yeah.
Do you mind if I go back to the shopping now?
No, go on, Noel. Sorry to disturb you, I'm just an idiot who doesn't know anything.
I know, Roland. Bye.
You think you know everything? I'm a star. Honolulu. I do wish you'd say something. It's so terribly boring dragging you around. You never say a word.
Here is your raclette, sir.
Oh, thanks, love. Oh, no. No, 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 no. I can't eat that. No, I don't like the look of that. I prefer fish and chips.
Typisch English. Jeder Engländer will fish and chips.
It's freezing out here. I don't know what these film stars see in every alpine retreat. It beats me. I'd rather be back home in the sewer. Well, I wonder if Errol has finished decorating the Christmas trees. I shall venture inside the chalet and find out. Oh no! What's he done now? I can't leave him alone for 5 minutes. Those leeks will have to go.
Errol was forced to redesign his tree yet again.
Cheek the leeks down, he said. Not Christmassy enough, he said. Well, I can tell you, Mr. Roland Rat, leeks are wonderful, whether you like it or not. However, I will now redecorate the tree, especially for Mr. Roland Rat. I don't mind, actually, because I got another idea that'll look wonderful.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the one we had before.
But we didn't have a white Christmas last year. Not in Leeds, anyway.
Oh, shut up, Kevin. It's in the song. Words in a song, isn't it? It's marvellous here, I must say, Kev. Yeah, you come up trumps finding this place, I must say.
You've done nothing but moan since we got here, Roland.
Yeah, well, I see it in a different light this morning, don't I, Kev? It's Christmas Eve anyway, isn't it? Got your Christmas stocking ready?
Yes, Roland. I'll put it under the tree tonight. How will Father Christmas get in the chalet, Roland, as there's no chimney?
Through the front door, I expect, Kev.
No, that'll be locked.
Well, we'll have to leave it open then, won't we?
Oh, no. We can't do that, Roland. What about all our equipment?
We're halfway up a mountain, Kevin, in the middle of nowhere.
I don't care, Roland. We can't take the risk. So how will Father Christmas get in? He can't come through the front door. There's no chimney.
Through the window.
No, that'll be locked.
Oh, yeah, of course it will. It's like Fort Knox in there, isn't it? Well, old Santa Claus will take one look at our chalet, see it's all locked up, and he'll move on to his next port of call, won't he?
I know what I'll do. I'll leave a note for him outside the hut telling him he can't come in for broadcasting security reasons. And could he leave all our presents in a bag outside the door, please?
That's charming, that is. If I was Father Christmas and I saw your note, I'd tear it up and leave nothing. Locking him out. You can't do that. He has to have access to everybody's own, doesn't he? He's Father Christmas, isn't he? Oh, well, you do what you like. I'm going to see if Errol's redecorated the Christmas trees yet. I'll meet you in the village later, Kev. Bye. We'll keep a welcome in the hillside. Oh, no, Errol. What have you done now? Welsh dolls in national costume are not right to hang on a Christmas tree. Oh, give up. If you want anything done in this world, you've got to do it yourself.
No leeks, no dolls in Welsh national costume.
No, Errol. Happy Christmas. Look, lads, a it's a Pope.
That's not the Pope, that's St. Nicholas.
St. Nicholas, who's who?
Hey, Father Christmas has arrived early. Shall I give him my note now?
Yeah, that's not the real Father Christmas, that's some bloke dressed up.
Are you sure, Roland?
Yeah, that's the guy who works in the laundrette down the road. I recognise him. Hang on a minute. I'll speak to him in German. Peter Kernenzine Reagan Dicekleider. Yeah, look, he's responded to that.
What did you say to him, Roland?
I asked him if he'd clean these clothes. See his eyes light up. He thought he'd got some work.
Roland, it's time for us to hang our Christmas stockings up. And I've had a wonderful idea.
All right, Kev, go on. Back to the shellet and hang them up.
Dear Father Christmas, sorry you can't come in for broadcasting security reasons. Sorry, but could you possibly leave all your presents in our stockings hanging on the door? Sorry for the inconvenience, but I'm sure you'll understand. Best wishes, Kevin the Gerbil. P.S. Please take the leek pie, the rat cocktail, and the signed photo of Roland Rat Superstar. Christmas Day opening presents and sitting watching television with all the Christmas programmes on.
Yeah, fat chance of that up here. Right load of rubbish on the TV. Can't understand a word of it, Kev. Yeah, good job we bought our own entertainment, innit, lads?
Now, where are all the presents? Oh dear, doesn't seem to have left any. He's left a little note, though. Get lost, you stupid gerbil. Christmas greetings, Santa. Understand. He hasn't left any presents. I must have offended him with my note. Oh dear, we got no presents now. I'll have to tell Roland.
Oh, Kev, where are the presents in, eh?
He didn't leave any. He told me to get lost. We haven't got any presents now, Roland.
Yeah, fooled you, Kev. I wrote that on your note. I've got the stockings here, look. Here's yours, and here's mine, the big one.
Oh, so he did leave some after all.
Yeah, of course he did.
That was a very mean thing to do, Roland.
Can we open our presents now, Roland?
Yeah, all right, Kev. Yeah, these are all from me and Errol. There you are.
Thank you, Roland. And these are all for you from me and Errol.
Ooh, wonderful, eh, Kev? Yeah. Where is Errol anyway? He should be here.
He's organising a surprise.
What kind of a surprise?
If I tell you, it won't be a surprise, will it?
True, Kev, true. Anyway, go on, open your present. Let big ones from me.
Oh, Roland, I'm all excited.
Well, go on then, open them. Don't just stand there. Yeah, that present cost me £8, that did. I know you'll love it, though. It's something you've always wanted.
Oh, Roland, it's a signed picture of you. How wonderful. And some handkerchiefs with my initials on. Oh, no, it's got your initials on. Oh, well, that is unusual.
Yeah, open the other parcel. That's something you can wear. Again, I know you're going to like it, Kev. Yeah.
Oh, Roland, it's lovely. It's a Roland Rat T-shirt. How unusual, Roland. It's a bit big, perhaps.
Yeah, well, I'll wear it then. Open Errol's present now. Go on. I bet I know what it is. I bet it's a leek.
Oh, look. It's a chocolate-covered leek. And a diary in Welsh.
Well, that's no use then, is it? You can't read Welsh.
No, Roland, never mind. It's the thought that counts. You open your presents now. Go on.
Yeah, all right, Kev. I wonder who this is from. Oh, this is from you, isn't it, Kev? This looks good. What is it, then? Let's have a look. What is it, then?
It's a bottle opener, Roland.
No. Well, that's useful, isn't it? I suppose. Yeah, thanks, Kev. Now, what's this? Oh, this is from Errol, isn't it? Yeah. This looks like a picture, doesn't it? Now, wait a minute. Oh, look. It's a tray. Yeah. It's a tray from Wales. Look. That's horrible, that, isn't it? Oh, well, never mind. Look, there's a diary with it as well. Yeah, it's useful, isn't it? Diary, I like diaries. Oh, here's another one from you here, Kev. What we got here? Now, this looks like a diary.
It is, Roland.
Yeah, just what I wanted. Two diaries. Yeah, well, this is going to be good. This is from the big boss from the studios. So I bet this is an expensive present. Let's have a look.
Looks like a diary, Roland.
Yeah, you're right, Kev. A diary. What more could I ask for? An international superstar. And what do I get for Christmas? Three diaries, one tray from Wales and a bottle opener. How wonderful.
Yes, I expect you're very pleased, Roland. Now I think it's time for your surprise. I'll just see if Errol's ready. Yes, I think we're ready. Come on, Roland.
Hey, how wonderful, Kev, eh? What a surprise. All my Swiss fans, yeah. Pity I didn't understand what they said.
They said, Merry Christmas, Roland.
Yeah, nice. Merry Christmas, Kev.
Merry Christmas, Roland.
Merry Christmas, Roland.
Yeah. Here we are, Kev. My boy, we finally made it. 8 days late, but never mind. We're on top of the world here. Smell the air, Kev. Pure, clean air. This is... Oh, dear. I'm not used to it, am I, Kev?
A bit cleaner than in the sewer, Roland.
Yeah. Look at all that snow. Beautiful, isn't it, Kev? Beautiful. I wonder where our skiing instructor is then.
Is that him over there?
Where? Oh, could be, Kev. Come on. Oi, entschuldigen Sie bitte, ski instructor.
Here bin ich. Haven Sie Ihre Skis dabei?
What's he saying, Kev?
He's asking you if you've got your skis.
Of course I have. Here they are.
Schnall Sie an, Domkopf. Es ist schwierig, ohne zu fahren.
Oh dear. What's he saying, Kev?
He says put them on, stupid.
Good charming, I see. It's going to be like that, is it? Well, come on, Kev, put your skis on.
Oh dear, I've only got one ski. I must have left one behind at the chalet. I won't be able to go skiing now, will I, Roland?
Typical. Well, just you watch me. Yeah, you'll pick up a lot of tips from me, Kev.
Sind Sie endlich fertig?
I do wish you'd speak in English, mate. The cost of these lessons, you think the least you'd expect is the instructor to speak English.
Also, beginnen wir mit der ersten Lektion. Wir versuchen, das Gleichgewicht zu behalten. Das geht so. Wir heben hoch das rechte Bein und dann runter. Gut hinsehen. Und dann hoch das linke Bein.
I don't know what he's on about. Oh, slow down, will you? I don't really need these lessons anyway. I'll ski perfectly without taking lessons. These are for your benefit, Kev, so listen, right?
Also bitte, folgen Sie mir.
Oi, wait a minute. Oi, will you wait a minute? I've only just put my skis on. Here, Kev, you watch this. I'll show him up, instructor. Come on, Fritzy, I'll lead. We're off, Kev. Oh, this is no good. I can't ski with a foreigner. Don't understand a word he's saying. He's putting me off. It's all right for you laughing your head off. Leaving your skis back at the chalet was probably a deliberate move on your part, wasn't it, Kev? I'm only doing this for your benefit. I hope you realise that.
And I don't want to go skiing, Roland. I wish I was back at the chalet with Errol. I wonder what he's cooking for lunch.
Oh, welcome back, rat fans. I'm having a bit of trouble here with me cheese.
Well, that was a complete waste of time, wasn't it? The next time we go on the slopes, we find an English instructor for you, Kev. Yeah, not some foreigner who can't speak the lingo. He made me look a right fool falling all over the place.
Everyone falls over to start with when they're learning how to ski, Roland.
But I'm not learning how to ski. There's nothing wrong with my skiing, thank you, Kevin. The next time we go onto the slopes, you are going to ski, whether you like it or not. Come on, let's see what Errol's got cooking for us. Some cutlery delight, I expect. Come on. What on earth's going on in here? Errol, I know this place is a dump, but there's no point in burning it down.
Ah, Roland! You're back early. Well, the fondue is almost ready.
The what?
It's a traditional Swiss meal made up of melted cheese and wine. I thought I might knock it up for lunch.
Have you gone wrong somewhere, though, Errol?
Oh, good gracious me, no.
Then why the smoke?
It's part of the Swiss custom to eat your Swiss fondue in a smoke-filled room, Roland.
What a load of old rubbish. Come on, Kev. Let's go and find a transport cafe in the village before we get exfixitrated. Kevin, I'm bored. Kevin, I said I'm bored.
I heard you the first time.
Yeah, well, I'm bored. Stuck in this shack. Nothing to do. It's like being in cold, it's here. Freezing cold outside. I wish I was at home.
Most people would be very pleased to be on holiday in a luxury chalet in Switzerland, Roland. And Sarsfay is a very pretty little mountain village.
Yeah, but it's boring. Nothing to do. I want to see some action, Kev, some action.
Then why don't we go out for the day, Roland?
Where to?
Into the valley. It's pretty down there with all the little chalets and goats and cows grazing on the hillside.
Yeah, all right. Well, let's go and see a film. Have they got a cinema down there?
No, Roland, of course not. No cinemas.
Of course not. Someone might enjoy themselves. Any amusement arcades, then?
No, don't be silly, Roland.
Nothing. Well, there's not much point in going down there, then, is there?
Well, you don't have to come. I'm sure Errol would only be too pleased to go out for the day. He can drive the Ratmobile.
Wait a minute, that's my car. I'll drive it, thank you very much.
So you'll come, then?
Yeah, all right. As long as we can take a picnic. We could have a picnic somewhere around here, Kev. Ooh, I'm putting my foot down now, Kev. There's a shallot, Kev. Better than ours. Do you know what I was thinking about today, Kev? I really must take a driving test. Where's the cows then and the mountain goats? I can't see any. Where are they?
They're around here somewhere, Roland. Could we just stop for a second? I need to go to the toilet, please.
Yeah, we'll never get to see any mountain goats if we have to keep stopping for you to go to the toilet, Kevin.
This is the first time, actually, Roland. Will you excuse me?
Yeah, well, hurry up, because we haven't got all day. Yeah, I don't know. Meanwhile, we'll dip into our picnic. Yeah. Now, where is it? I thought Kevin prepared it somewhere here in the car. There's cheese sandwiches, apples, chocolates, chocolate biscuits. And where is it? Perhaps he's put it in the boot.
Roland, I'm ready now. What are you doing?
No, you're back quick, aren't you, Kev? Actually, I'm looking for our picnic. Where is it?
Oh, dear, the picnic. I've totally forgotten to bring it. Oh, silly me.
You fool. The only reason for me coming on this day out was for the food.
Yeah, well, I can't remember everything, can I?
You didn't have to remember anything else, only the picnic.
Yes, well, I forgot it.
Fine. Well, it's ruined our day out, hasn't it?
Don't be silly, Roland. We can have it when we get back to the chalet.
All right. I'll let you off. Let's find some mountain goats and cows clanging their cowbells. There must be some somewhere around here. Come on, Kev.
There, Roland, look! Swiss mountain goats! Go
Come on!
Oh, that ugly cave!
Take a picture of me, Roland, with the mountain goats. Listen to the bells clanging.
All right, Cave, I've got the camera here. Right. Right, Cave, back a bit.
Where? Here?
Yeah, back a bit more.
Oh, over here. Over here, Roland. I've trodden in something.
What's brown and sounds like a bell, Kev?
Bun?
Dang! That's a good minute, Kev.
No, that's a very old joke, Roland. Not very funny.
Well, keep still. I'm going to take the picture. Can't see a thing through this. I wish we'd got a new camera, Kev. How much did you pay for this load of rubbish? It's years old. Should be in a museum. Where are you? All right, got you in the picture now, Kev. Yeah. Yeah. Got it. You can't come in the car now. You'll have to clean your shoes first.
Oh, Roland, don't be silly.
I'm not having that smell in my car. No, clean your shoes. No, better still. Take them off. Give them here. Come on, give them here. And I'll put them in the boot. Yeah. Yeah. That solved that little problem, didn't it?
My feet are cold now.
Serves you right. You should look where you're treading in future. Well, we've seen the Swiss mountain goats, so what's next on the agenda?
Swiss cows.
Right, where are they?
How should I know?
You know everything about this country, Kevin. You speak the lingo.
What's wrong with the car, Roland?
This is all we need.
Is this a problem in the car, Roland?
Yeah. We've run out of petrol, Kev. You'll have to walk to the nearest garage.
But I haven't got any shoes on, Roland.
We'll take him out the boot then. Go on.
Oh, all right.
She's wonderful, isn't it? No food, now no petrol. What a marvellous way to spend a day out.
Why do I always get the rotten jobs? Ich möchte gern Benzin haben, bitte.
Ach, stinkt das. Ist das von Ihren Füßen?
Ja, es tut mir leid. Es ist Mist.
Ach, stinkt das. Hier haben Sie es, grauenhaft.
Dankeschön. I got this petrol free due to my shoes smelling. I found some petrol, Roland.
Oh, Kevin. Oh, morning. Where am I? I must have dozed off.
You did.
That smells back again. Go and take your shoes off, Kev.
All right, but first I'll put the petrol in. Do you just pour it in the boot?
Of course you don't, Kevin. There's a petrol cap, you fool. Pour it in there. He's got no idea, has he?
I found the hole for the petrol, Roland. Pouring it in now.
I've had enough of this day out, Lark. I want to go back to the chalet.
There we are. It's all in now. Why, Roland?
Well, for a bit of peace and quiet. And also, the picnic's waiting to be eaten, isn't it? And I'm starving. So, let's head on up the valley, eh, Kev? Got the map?
No, I gave it to you in the chalet.
I've left it in the chalet then, haven't I?
See, even superstars forget things.
Yeah. Well, I never forget anything, Kevin. Remember that. I never forget anything.
Well, you've forgotten the maps, haven't you?
All right, Noel. Come on. What a great idea to have a picnic, eh, Kev?
It's my idea, Roland.
Oh, look at it. Vast expanse there. Vast expanse of valley.
Oh, isn't it pretty in the valley, Roland? I do love Switzerland.
Oh, look, Kev, there's a church.
Oh, can we take a picture of it, Roland?
No, sorry, Kev, no time. Got to get back to the chalet for the picnic, you fool. Picnic. Fantastic. What brilliant acting there. Well, we're at the end of the tape now, Rat Fan, so rewind and play it again. But don't forget, the story continues in Volume 2 of Roland's Winter Wonderland.